Hello everyone, my name is Diego. I'm going to talk a little bit about my research in inverse opals. So just a little bit, quick outline of this presentation. I'm gonna give a brief background on the topic of photonic crystals. Then we're gonna go to objectives and the experimental results we have obtained. Finally, move on to conclusions and future work. So photonic crystals are periodically ordered microstructures. They're built from dielectric materials, and the periodicity of these materials is in the range of the visible wavelength. So diffraction and interference caused by the periodic structure generates a band gap in the photonic structure, similar to the electronic band gap in semiconductors. And this results in a bright angle-dependent coloration of the material that comes from the structure itself and not from a light absorbent molecule like a dye, which is the most common kind of coloration. In nature, we can find several examples of structural color, such as the opal gemstone, which is a closed packed array of silica spheres. We also have very beautiful examples in insects, such as the Japanese jewel beetle that has a multi-layer structure in its shell, which results in this very bright green color. And one of the most common known examples is the blue morpho butterfly, which has this Christmas tree-like structure in the wing scales, and that gives this very bright, beautiful blue color. So the color of these materials, or the optical properties of these materials, have to do with some of physical parameters of the structure, such as the lattice spacing, the size of this periodic structure, the refractive index contrast between the two phases, the two different phases, and also the degrade of symmetry and the grade of order that we have in the structure. So the objective of this project is to design and assemble composite photonic crystals in order to study the optical properties and look into how to tune these optical properties. So experimentally, we can obtain photonic crystals in the form of opals by self-assembly of polymer colloids in solution by vertical deposition. We can also obtain the inverse structure, the inverse opal, by making this assembly in a solution containing a precursor of silica, for example, or any other ceramic, dielectric ceramic. And then when we dry this and calcinate it, we get rid of the polymer template, and we are only left with our inverse opal structure. So the resulting species, as expected, exhibit angle-dependent coloration, which is characteristic of these structures. They have a face-centered cubic structure, particularly with the 111 plane lined up with the surface of the material. The optical properties can be tuned by changing the polymer colloid size used for templating the structure. So here we work with a range between 240 up to 1,000 nanometers. And additionally, it was found that when we sputter coat a metallic layer on top of these structures, for example, a silver layer, we see a very important change in the optical properties of the materials, probably because of new effects being induced, such as plasmonic resonance in the metallic layer. In terms of color tuning, we were able to obtain a change in coloration. For example, in this sample is a 240 nanometer inverse opal sputter coated with silver. And when we infiltrate this structure with ethanol, we are basically changing the refractive index contrast between the two phases. And that results in a change in coloration from a bright orange when the structure is infilled with air, to a deep blue when it's infilled with ethanol. And we can see that in the spectra as a drop in the 600 nanometers reflectance. So to conclude, we have been able to fabricate these photonic structures by self-assembly in a vertical deposition method with a vertical deposition method, the samples or the structures present angle-dependent coloration, characteristic of photonic structures. And future work will be based around working with smart materials in order to try to actively tune the photonic structure and the optical properties of these materials. Looking forward to maybe using these materials for applications such as sensing, color display devices, and yeah. Thank you very much. If anyone has any questions.